We have the 16mm T1.2 and the 75mm to add to their current lineup, which was 24, 35, and 50? Yes, 50. I forgot. I don't have the other ones with me because they are in Canada and I'm in Taiwan right now. They are very consistent with the performance of the initial set. That means that these two don't match at all. If you look at these shots right here, the whole cast is warmer than the other one. There would be three different color casts in terms of the five lenses with the whole lens set. As a cine lens set, it has to be consistent. But what's consistent about these ones is the filter thread. They're all 67 millimeters. The placement of the gears, they're all the same. So the build quality on these ones, fairly similar. I really like the gray silver finish and it just matches really well with the FX3, FX30. So the focus ring is a little bit loose, consistent to the initial set. And then the iris gear is quite dampened. So it's quite good. Again, it's consistent with the rest of the set. I just discovered this while I was filming this video. Look at this, like talk about build quality. This is moving right here. You hear that? Yeah. Well, this is a sample only, so I'll give them a pass, but I don't know if this is going to bleed into the production copies. So just watch out for that. The minimum focus distance, especially with the 16mm, I'm really disappointed because it should be closer. I've had the Sigma 16mm and I was able to focus quite great with it. Just the overall minimum focus distance of the whole set is quite subpar compared to other lenses, Super 35 lenses. But what I like about the Nightwalker lenses is the minimum focus breathing. That's what they did right with these ones. I do like the bokeh on the 75 as well. I feel like the 75 millimeter would be my favorite out of the whole five lenses. The 16 is good because 24 millimeter on a Super 35 isn't really wide enough. It'll be equivalent to 35 millimeter on full frame. Anyways, so this would be equivalent to 24 millimeters. This would be kind of like a true wide angle than the 24 millimeter on Super 35. So this is what a lot of people were looking for, and maybe like a little telephoto action. And I think these two really complete the set. Wide open at T1.2, the chromatic aberration is there, and it resolves itself around T2.8. At T1.2, you're gonna have more light in. Mind you, your depth of field is going to be super, super shallow. Good luck focusing with T1.2. But it helps with low light. It helps with getting the right exposure in the sensor. If you want sharpness in your shot, shoot around T4 and you're gonna get some crispy shots. If you want something soft, something really bloomy or dreamy, cinematic, shoot at T1.2, T1.4. At 1.8 as well. Even T2 is still pretty soft in these ones. Overall, for the price, I feel like it's great for what it is. Like, you're gonna have similar problems, you're gonna have similar shortcomings, but you're also gonna have similar pros with these ones. And when you know the weaknesses and the pros of your gear, the better you are adapting into anything that comes at you in terms of video production. That's it for my review of the new additions to the Sirui Nightwalkers, the 16mm and the 75mm. If you have any questions with these two new additions, let me know in the comments down below, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.